What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. I'm Steven. This is Steven in Stereo, and today it's gonna be deep, I'm pretty sure. This is gonna be Demi Lovato's new track, Anyone. This is the lyric video. I won't be doing the Grammy performance because I did watch it live. One thing about watching it live though, you're around a bunch of people, everyone's kind of talking, everything's kind of going on. I didn't really get a chance to really give this the appreciation that I felt like it deserved. So when I saw that she had the lyric video up, I knew this was the perfect thing to do, to be able to just literally take in everything that she was saying. I mean, obviously watching her on that stage crying, this song hit so hard for her. And so I thought the best thing we could do is listen to it on this channel. So that's enough of an intro. Let's go ahead and check this out and let's hear Demi Lovato speak what's on her mind. So I've heard a little bit, and I don't know the full history of the song, so if I get this wrong right now, please let me know in the comment section. But I heard that she actually wrote this before everything happened last year. So all of this was already written, and then we kind of know what happened. No reason to really talk about it. And so it's very interesting to, if that is true, to look at these lyrics and see where she was at in her life prior to those moments, because I feel like it's almost like haunting. Like I have goosebumps, kind of like, I don't know, putting myself in her head, in her shoes, and just kind of like where you're at in your life when you're writing the song. So if that is true, it definitely hits, I don't know, way deeper. Yeah, I just feel like even right now, I can feel goosebumps. It's just like, almost like she knew something was going to happen. She's trying so hard to get, I'm not even gonna say that she's getting anyone, but literally just needed one person to hear her crying, to hear her going through so much torture in her mind that led her to what ended up happening. And it's just, I don't know. It's like amazing when you can get this sort of insight as someone's going through something, so that when they end up on the other side of it and you hear the story, it just, I don't know, it's deep. I feel like I can relate to Demi on some levels here. Me anywhere, Lord, is there anywhere? I need somewhere, oh, anywhere, please send me anywhere, Lord, is there anywhere? I need again, getting that insight and really getting to see what she was going through, I feel like there's so much that so many people can relate to. And it really is crazy how when she says, like, nobody's listening to me, like, she needed one person to be there that wasn't, like, you know, in love with her for her music or any of that. Just someone that was there for her as a person. And you can hear it coming out in the cries in the song. And, you know, when you talk about Demi Lovato, it's easy to go straight to vocals. Her vocal capabilities are so insane. She has such an amazing voice, an amazing range. Watching some of her live performances that I have on this channel, I'm consistently blown away with what she does live. I mean, and that's an understatement. Hearing it in this song, though, hearing it so broken brings it to a whole nother level, because you can just hear sadness in her voice, even if this is recorded now in a much more recent time. She's still harboring those feelings that she had then, enough to put them into the song and give you that same emotion. And I think there's just so much to be appreciated in a song like this. And I think there's a lot of people out there that can hear the song and feel like they're not alone, if that makes sense. I feel like you can hear this and you can picture yourself in a way, you know, writing something like this, saying something like this. If you had to get off your chest what you were going through. A lot of these words she's using, a lot of the phrases that she's using, because what I love here is that she didn't take complex lyricism here. She is speaking exactly how she feels, and it's almost like a therapy session in a sense, and it's just crazy. Nobody's listening. I talk to shooting stars, but they always get it wrong. I feel stupid when I pray. Why the fuck am I praying anyway? If nobody's listening anyway, please send me anyway. Lord, is there anyone? I need someone. Oh, anyway, please send me anyway. Oh, Lord, God damn. Anyone? Just hearing the pain in her voice, just hearing that sadness, that hopelessness, I just feel like it creates a vibe, it creates an energy that is both disturbing, and what I mean by that is it's like uncomfortable, because you can relate on so many levels. At least someone like me going through things that I'm going through, you can relate a little bit. But more than that, having empathy and realizing as an artist, as a human being, artist aside, as a human being, being in that situation and then all for everything to come crashing down, just, you know, what? I think it's like just a little bit after that, right? Like this was like very, this was written very close to when everything happened. And I just feel, again, I'm gonna repeat myself here, but getting insight like that as a person is going through probably what feels like the hardest, lowest moment in their life, and then being able to be on the outside of it, but not just pretending like it didn't happen, but acknowledging it with so much power and strength. That's where I feel like you have to appreciate artists like Demi Lovato, who are willing to put themselves out there in public in a way that some people might, have a negative opinion about, or might not like to talk about those things because they're scary. Yeah, that shit's fucking scary, but it's real. It's happened. It happens to so many people. And when you can relate to an artist like Demi on that level, you realize that you're not alone. And when you listen to the song, she felt so alone in this moment. And you're able to listen to the song, listen to these lyrics, and realize that if you're feeling like that, it's okay to try to reach out. And it seems like Demi exhausted her options. She didn't feel like there was anyone, even though, you know, she's got the millions of fans, all this money. The important thing is that none of those things really matter at the end of the day, because those things can't change what your brain does and how it thinks. And it can't give you that happiness. And fuck, I mean, just again, I'm like kind of in shock you know, when I watch the live performance, I can see the sadness, but sometimes it's hard to really capture everything that's happening, especially when you've never heard the song. So to be able to actually look at the lyrics, I'm just amazed and I'm very much impressed. And good for Demi. This is a great comeback for her, and so many people are going to be supportive of this because they can relate, me being one of them. I hope you guys liked today's video. If you did, please make sure to like the video, subscribe to the channel. You guys can follow me on Instagram and Twitter. Links are always in the description. Thank you guys so much. I'll see you in the next one. Peace.